It is a game of two traditions. On one side, Rockne and a touchdown Jesus. On the other, the general and a checkerboard end zone. It's been 10 years since they last met at South Bend. And the memory of a remarkable comeback remains burned into the legends of both schools. Today, the rivalry renews. The Orange and the Irish showdown at South Bend. Live from Notre Dame Stadium, here are your hosts, Rudy Kalis and Mark Packer.
A beautiful day in South Bend, Indiana, and a beautiful day for football in the Midwest. Welcome to all of you.
Yeah, the Vols and Fighting Irish now just about 30 minutes away from renewing an old rivalry. They played a couple years ago. We're talking about the miracle of South Bend back in 91. Hello, everybody. I'm Mark Packer from WBIR in Knoxville.
And I'm Rudy Kalis from WSMV-TV in Nashville, and you had the great idea that let's do this together and give nearly the entire state a preview look at a Volunteers game against Notre Dame.
I'll bet we've got about two-thirds of the state, and I wish everyone at home could be here. You've been here before.
Yeah.
But, Rudy, this is awesome.
This is awesome, but it's different. Back in 91 when we were here, the wind chill was zero at the point when we did a broadcast before the start of the game. They've also added 21,000 seats along the top, so when you sit in the end zone, you don't see touchdown Jesus anymore. You got to peek over the top end of the stadium, but it meant more ball fans are in here.
You got to be at the very top. But let's look back, if we can. Let's start about the 91 game. What do you remember about that?
Well, I just remember the conditions of the weather-wise. At that time, though, Notre Dame, I think, favored to come into the game. Tennessee playing in here, and we were concerned they'd get caught up in the mystique of everything that happens here. So as we go back, it's kind of interesting to see how the day unfolded, how the game unfolded, realizing they'd played the year before. Let's go back to 91.
Minutes ago. Toward the end zone!
Tennessee's loss to Notre Dame in Knoxville in 1990 was still a burning memory as the Volunteers headed for South Bend in 91 for a rematch with Lou Holtz and the Irish.
Great day to work.
It snowed the day before the game, but the field was cleared. And before Johnny Major's team could blink an eye, the Irish had dismantled the Volunteers, leading 21-0 in the first quarter. They upped that lead to 31-7.
You know, it may sound crazy, but we were actually pretty confident at halftime that we were going to come back and make a game of it. And I don't think there was a lot of doubt in our minds that we were going to come back. Now, I probably wouldn't have bet my life savings at that time that we were going to win, but I was confident we were going to come back and make a game of it.
It was 31-14 in the third quarter when senior quarterback Andy Kelly led one of the great charges in Vols history. He hit Corey Fleming in the corner of the end zone and then in the final minutes flipped a screen to Aaron Hayden, who put the Vols on top by one.
Touchdown!
But Notre Dame had one more chance, drove within field goal range in the final seconds and lined up to try to win the game.
The field goal was on this end of the field. I looked at this end of the field and I could see the Tennessee section and the Notre Dame section. And then all at once, I saw the Tennessee section stand up, and I knew something good had happened. I didn't actually know we'd blocked it or what Jeremy had done, but I just saw the Tennessee fans start cheering, and I looked up, and I saw our guys running on the field. So I just took off running on the field and tried to find somebody to hug. I knew something good had happened.
They had to find somebody to hug. I know those of us up in the press box, a lot of people almost jumped out. Couldn't believe how they'd come back. The crowd was stunned.
Yeah.
And Tennessee was just whooping it up.
And one guy, just talking about the 91 game here, said, I was sitting up in the upper row, the top. I remember running down to the field, storming the field, and Andy Kelly was saying, there's nothing like this. There's nothing like this.
And yet, Andy was a Tennessee boy who had initially walked out and said, ain't no big deal. I mean, it's just, you know, just the stadium.
And as it turned out, Philip Fulmer was right in the middle of all of that. He, of course, is now Tennessee's head football coach, but 10 years ago he was the offensive coordinator and he was right in the middle of all of the action.
I guess the thing I remember the most was it was almost like it was in slow motion, you know, when you were calling those plays and you could see things happening and you kind of had a feel for it, and particularly on the touchdown, you know, you saw the blitz getting ready to come and you knew if it just picked up like we wanted it to be and executed that it was going to be a touchdown. And it was just as perfect as it could have been ever imagined that it happened that way.
With a sensational call as Tennessee anticipates the blitz.
I remember the halftime, that there was no panic. This is what we have to do to get back into it. that we felt like we could if we could just hold them some on defense, you know, if we could just keep them from getting more points, that we had a chance to go back out there and get it done. And the block field goal before half, I think, made a big difference, you know, to get that score and go in with some momentum and some excitement. And there was guys mad at themselves and everything, but ready to go.
To the 45, to the 40. Floyd Miley can fly. Floyd Miley has the ball at the 15, at the 10, at the 5. He has gone all the way. Touchdown, Big Orange.
Notre Dame is the history and the great teams and the great games that, you know, that's special for all of us to be a part of. Now, our kids certainly understand that the field's the same length and width, and nobody in the stands can make a tackle and all those kind of things. So it's going to be the 11-on-11 on the field.
The kick is up. The kick is good. No, it is no good. It is no good. It is no good. Tennessee beats Notre Dame 35-34.
You know, I thought it was funny yesterday at the Vols walkthrough that Philip was talking about. He said, the weather's going to be a lot different, but I'll take the same result if you offer it to me right now.
That's exactly what he said. And the field itself is just a little different. It's a little softer.
It's slower.
It seems slower than Tennessee's feet. I think they want to slow down the Volunteers as part of what they want to do.
Sure. We've got a story coming up on a guy you know very well.
Oh, yes. Travis Stevens. When we come back, we'll take a look at the fifth-year senior from Clarksville who's had a whale of a season with the Volunteers and the Big Orange.
And we'll check in on the mystique of Notre Dame. And when you talk about the mystique, you start with Touchdown Jesus. That and more as we continue.
The more life stays the same, the more you want food that's different. Like the original Crystal, our famous burger on a steamed square bun. Now get a sack full of 10 for $4.99. Crystal, little food, big taste.
I've known Joe Holquist in this town for many years. Joe understands how to grow communities, how to protect neighborhoods. But more than that, he understands the potential of the future of this town. Joe's no one's fool. He listens to all sides, he's a fair person, and he's a smart guy. That's what we need on the city council in this town. It's a clear choice in this race, and I'm very proud to support Joe Holquist.
It's the simplest things that mean so much, like calling up to stay in touch. A simple thing, a simple song to sing.
Knoxville is my hometown. It really is my heart and soul. I had a wonderful childhood here, always working to make a difference and learning all those life lessons that make me who I am today.
Hi, I'm Mark Brown, and I want to work for you on City Council. I want the same Knoxville you do, with safe neighborhoods, a thriving economy, a place we'd be proud to leave our children. A vote for Mark Brown is a vote for you.
Vote Mark Brown, the right choice, the right voice for City Council.
We're just 20 minutes away from the kickoff between Tennessee and Notre Dame. These two teams don't play each other very, very often. They played in 99. The last time they played here, we've talked about in 1991, but they still call it a rivalry.
Yeah, it's a rivalry. I think everybody's Notre Dame's rival. You talk about USC, Michigan, Florida State, and Tennessee, just because anytime you've got two teams that have the tradition both of these programs have, they both consider the other team to be a rival.
Well, the last time they played, Tennessee played against Notre Dame, was in Knoxville a couple of years ago. Yep. The final score was 38-14. The Volunteers manhandled Notre Dame. And I think afterwards, Bob Davie, the head coach of the Irish, said, we learned that we need to get more athletes, quicker athletes, and Tennessee was a much better football team than us. But there is something extra when every team comes and plays against Notre Dame. This Tennessee team is no different. They're making the trip to South Bend. Several players calling this hallowed ground when it comes to college football.
All I know is every time Notre Dame and Tennessee get together, except for 2 years ago, that something wild and woolly happens, and It's decided in the last few minutes of the game.
I know there's a rich tradition at Notre Dame, and that's because I just told the rest of the guys, anytime someone makes a movie about your school, it has to be something there.
I always used to watch Notre Dame on Saturdays. Being Catholic and going to Catholic schools throughout my whole school background and stuff like that. I was real interested in Notre Dame and watching them.
Just listening to them play, we feel the same way when we came here and kind of see all of this. You think about Newt Rockne, the Four Horsemen, right. And I'm getting a lot of people hollering, Rudy, Rudy. That movie just wore me out.
Well, I asked Casey yesterday. Now, Casey was raised Catholic and had been a Notre Dame fan growing up. And I asked him yesterday at the Hall of Fame, just said, if they had offered you, would you have gone to Notre Dame? And he said, no, because they run the ball too much. I needed to go somewhere where they throw the football. And at Tennessee, they had a chance to throw the football. But they're doing a lot of running with the guy that you saw in high school.
Oh, man, Travis Stevens is dynamite. Dynamite. He's a great player. The Volunteers have wanted him, needed him, and now he's coming into his own. I like people with patience. So Travis Stevens is a guy.
He's been extremely patient. He's waited for his chance, and he's got 1 year to prove it. Josh Rowe has that story.
When Travis Stevens came to UT, he didn't come alone. With the freshman class overloaded with running backs, Travis knew he'd have to wait his turn.
It's a blessing to have that patience that I had to wait those many, for those years that I had to wait and finally get the opportunity. And I'm just enjoying the moment right now.
It's a moment many thought would never come. After the Vols brought in a new group of talented freshman runners, few thought Travis would be the starter this season. But he overcame his doubters with his faith and a good attitude.
I prayed about it in this offseason, and he put it in me to be successful, to prove these people wrong. I'm just thankful right now. I don't like when people actually doubt me or talk bad about me, but it's good to have a smile, a frown every day, and it's not going to get me anywhere.
No one's doubting Travis now. He's not only the starter, he leads the SEC in rushing. Gaining ground with a lot of enthusiasm and a lot of heart.
And that's how I play the game, because I'm not that big, and most people think with my size that I couldn't be durable or say make it in this sport. But I'm doing it because of my heart.
He is a tremendous athlete, tremendous football player, got a great heart, and I'm real happy for him and what he's done, and being real patient. It's 4 or 5 years here at Tennessee, and now it's his time to shine, and he's doing a great job with it, and he's a tremendous player.
I'm very happy. This is one of the happiest moments in my life right now, and I'm just going to continue to enjoy this happiness.
You know, and Rudy, it's interesting that before the season, everybody had written Travis Stevens off, that one of these Herald and Parade All-American tailbacks would come in and take over the position. They just get a commitment from Gerald Riggs Jr. out of Chattanooga Red Bank this past week. They're loaded at tailback, and Travis said, I'm the guy.
But he was that way. We loved him in high school. We'd go to all of his games because he always said he didn't care who he was playing. He was going to take care of business. You know who he reminds me of? You watch him, he'll run like Tony Dorsett. Tony Dorsett, relating it to this game, because Tony Dorsett, when he was at Pittsburgh, tore up Notre Dame on this field for almost torched him for almost 300 yards. So let's see what he does today.
And you talk about someone who tears up the opposition. Another guy that Middle Tennessee saw a lot was Pearl Cone's John Henderson. Big Bad John will have his story as we continue to get ready for Tennessee Notre Dame in just a minute.
Free 2,183 suits, free 1,154 sport coats, free 442 blazers, free 1,888 dress slacks. It's the men's clothing event of the year. It's at American Clothing. Buy one suit, get one free. Buy one sport coat or blazer, get one free. Buy one suit but don't need a second, get a sport coat or blazer plus a pair of dress slacks absolutely free. It's that simple. Free clothing, sizes 36 to 56. It's the men's clothing event of the year now at American Clothing, across from Westtown Mall.
A little Sunday sports talk.
In those uniforms, the red and the white just don't go with the green field.
Clueless.
Guys, it's Alabama. They have no fashion sense.
Not. Watch the game on Saturday, then break it down with our sports gurus, Jimmy Hyams, Heath Shuler, and Mark Packer. Here's your chance to analyze, criticize, or get some answers about the big game. Sunday Sports Talk, Sunday at 10 a.m. on Channel 10. It's not your mama's talk show. Unless, of course, your mama loves sports.
If Action 10 News just feels right, it may be that credibility still means something. We built Doppler 10 radar 20 years ago. Today, it remains the only privately operated weather radar in East Tennessee. Because your life doesn't revolve around our schedule, there's 10 News 2. Anything worth doing is worth repeating. And because sometimes a smile is all that's needed, we offer Positively Schwa. All unique and all reasons, Action 10 News is straight from the heart.
I want to hold down your property taxes through economic development, by expanding existing business and by recruiting new business. Private business will take a risk. We just need to give them the reason. We need to give them the incentives to take a risk. I've listened and I've learned, and people want more participation in their government. They want more debate. They want more open discussion. I need your support and your vote to help move Knoxville forward.
The Tennessee flag flies high above Notre Dame Stadium. It's one of the symbols of sportsmanship here, yes, at Notre Dame. And Rudy, we were just listening to some people as we were coming into the stadium said, when was the last time you walked into the stadium that someone says, welcome to our stadium? What'd they say?
Vanderbilt.
They said Vanderbilt.
They're very cordial at Vanderbilt in that respect as well. But you're right, the atmosphere is wonderful. They're cordial. They want to win badly. They got some tough guys behind us that want to take care of that business.
Now, they may be rivals, but they got a good relationship.
Wonderful relationship and a neat kind of a, well, when Notre Dame, you think of all the people that have played here in the past, so it's fun to look back and then see the Tennessee connection between, right, Notre Dame and Tennessee. Let's look back.
Ladies and gentlemen.
The mystique of Notre Dame, the lady on the dome, touchdown Jesus overlooking the stadium, a school and a football program steeped in tradition, Newt Rockne, the four horsemen, the luck of the Irish. But there's also a Tennessee connection. Longtime Vols fans will remember 1956 when the Golden Boy, Paul Horning of the Irish, and Tennessee's Johnny Majors were the front runners for the Heisman Trophy.
I was aware of everybody who was a significant football player in 1956. In fact, since I was a little guy, I've been pretty aware of the great players around the country in all sports. But I remember, I knew what Horning was doing, and their season wasn't too good. 2-8 or something like that, and we were 10-0.
I always say that I led Notre Dame in the worst season they ever had in the history of their school, 2-8. You know, they knew if you stopped Horning, we didn't have much. And I think everything just kind of snowballed. I wasn't even thinking about the Heisman Trophy. I mean, my heavens, Johnny Majors was having a sensational year at Tennessee. You had Jim Brown, you had John Brody, you had Lenny Dawson. I always kidded Johnny Majors. He absolutely felt that he should have won the Heisman Trophy. We've kidded about it.
And he caught me off guard. He says, Johnny, you really thought you should have won the Heisman rather than me? And I says, no, Paul, I thought Jimmy Brown should have won it.
Johnny Majors with a sense of humor. The intensity is magnifying here on the field itself. We mentioned to you Andy Kelly was going to try to be with us, but he's still working his way through the crowd. He's not able to join us, but we heard from him. I guess we found, though.
We saw this guy. He was hanging out of the stadium down here on the front row. And Adam the Leprechaun, what are you yelling?
Huh?
What were you yelling?
I was yelling, go Irish, let's go, get them fired up, big game. So getting the students ready to go. They're all green, they're ready to go, fight the orange. Big game today.
You've got a lot of responsibility to get these people going, don't you?
I know, I'm ready. There's a lot of them today, so you got to fight all that orange in the crowd, so it should be a blast. I'm pumped up, Blake.
Adam, we can tell. Good luck to you.
Sorry, all right, guys, have a good time. Enjoy the game.
Go run off and get him.
All right.
There he goes. Adam's leaving.
Okay. Adam's wired.
He is. Now, we took a look early in the show, Rudy, about Travis Stevens, but another guy from your part of the state in Middle Tennessee, Don Henderson, has made big waves in college football.
We called him Baby Shaq when he was little. We thought he was going to play basketball. Watched him grow up ever since he was a young kid. Man, is he a man.
And now he's changed to this Big Bad John. Seth Andrews has his story.
Big John. Big John.
Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.
John Henderson could have easily made a run for the money in the NFL, but instead he chose to return to Knoxville to chase down opposing runners and help the Vols win a title.
Big Bad John.
Well, I wouldn't trade it because it's something that I can always look back on and just remember and just say, you know, that's the college years and playing college football was the greatest.
Speaking of great, that sums up John's junior season. His dominating performances earned him the Outland Trophy. This year has been a little more frustrating for John. An ankle injury in the opener against Syracuse has kept him at less than 100%. Plus, there's the constant double-teaming. But John doesn't blame them for trying.
I mean, it was tough at first. Then you just got to get used to it. You got to learn how to defeat the double-team. You got to go out there and give it an unbelievable effort every time. And just basically do your job, and you're going to wind up getting open sooner or later and making plays.
The way he plays the game, it's going to be a hard-fought football game. If you don't have two guys ready to play to block him, then somebody's going to be in for a long day.
John's winding down his career at Tennessee, but he hopes people will be talking about him for years to come.
He was one of the greatest players here, and that's what you like. You know, you want to hear things like that you gave a great contribute to the University of Tennessee.
I don't think John has anything to worry about.
Big Bad John.
This is what you call the color of college football. This is the pageantry. Notre Dame Stadium, the Fighting Irish band on the field. We are now 14 minutes and 37 seconds away from kickoff. We'll wrap up this show and get you ready for Tennessee Notre Dame when we come back.
Support the candidate who will support you. Bedford Chapman, City Council.
A member of council should reflect honesty and integrity. I will watch every penny of your tax dollar. I will protect the integrity of neighborhoods.
Support the candidate who will support you. Bedford Chapman, City Council.
New York City Fire Department suffered a devastating loss of the World Trade Center towers. Their bravery was inspiration to us all. The events of September 11th left a lasting impact on East Tennessee, along with a need to do something. If you're looking for another way to help New York City, make a contribution to help purchase a new fire truck. It's one more way that East Tennessee can show New York we honor their courage. Make your donation at any First Tennessee Bank or mail it to the Freedom Engine, care of First Tennessee, Knoxville, 37995-1000.
East Tennessee has a gift for story of journeys made, wild places, wild things, tales from tellers young and old. The Heartland series has woven these stories into its newest home videotape, Volume 21. Each tape in the Heartland series collection is $29.95. Special editions just $19.95 and $14.95. It's a gift to share. The Heartland series featuring Volume 21. Now available at Heartland Antiques in Sevierville and the Mountain Heritage Collection at the Farmer's Market.
We are back again just moments now, 12 minutes away from the start of the game. Head coach Philip Fulmer on the field. We've got plenty of police protection behind us. It's a neat atmosphere. Volunteer fans, Mark, are up near the top, aren't they?
Rudy, I'll say this again. I wish everybody at home could be here. Down here looking up and just seeing you've got green, you've got blue, you've got gold, and you've got a lot of orange.
Oh, yeah.
Scattered throughout the
orange
stadium.
Orange fans come from all over. And the new 21,000 seats that they added gave them a lot more opportunity. This place was built in 1930. It is close. It is tight. It is old time. Football, yeah. Got a fun feel to it. Now, one of the other neat things that they've built in this town since we were here in 1991 was the College Football Hall of Fame, and we got a chance to stop over there yesterday along with the Tennessee team. And Mark, I thought it was quite a gesture on the part of Philip Fulmer, not just to take the team to a motel, not just to talk about the game coming up, but to look at the wonderful history of the game.
And they truly enjoyed it. About a 15-minute video they watched on college football. Then after the Hall of Fame, they went over here to Notre Stadium for the walkthrough. It's kind of that last chance to come out here, relax, get accustomed to the field, and get used to what they're going to see today at kickoff time. The walkthrough yesterday, something that brought back a lot of memories to some Tennessee football players because they were recruited by Notre Dame as well as Tennessee. There is indeed a common bond between both programs.
They recruit nationally. A lot of our kids were recruited by Notre Dame, so they certainly have I think, a full appreciation and understanding of what the opportunities lie here for them.
So we are now just a few minutes away. The band is playing, and this is college football, Rudy.
It's a wonderful feeling out playing with beautiful, spacious skies. I thought I liked what Philip Homer saying again, letting the players see where they came from. And John Henderson looked genuinely, when he was in the Hall of Fame, looked so embarrassed to see himself inside the football Hall of Fame. He'll realize it as he gets older, but it's just a great moment.
And they all stopped at the General Nealon plaque to read that and see the history of Tennessee, and I think it was good for him.
Well, all neat stuff when you come here and play. When we were here in 1991, Mark, Lou Holtz was the head coach. We were here all week long. He got tired of seeing the media around. We were inside of the bubble where they were practicing one time, and all of a sudden he turned to us and he said, "Turn that camera off!" Hollered at us, and had 120 football players absolutely stop. He said, "Give me that tape." Thought we were spying on him. Then he comes over later and he taps me on the shoulder. He said, "Hey, you're okay. You're all right. Don't worry about it. Just shoot what you want." And the players were frothing. So the psychological effect is amazing.
And oh, spacious skies. Let's pause for just a moment. We're going to stop talking and just let you listen for just a moment to the atmosphere of Notre Dame Stadium.
Spirit of this country. I think we realize in September there is more to life than just games, that this is a game. Right. We will love it. We will enjoy the intensity of it. But this beautiful country and the freedom we have is just most important.
The security is more intense. The dogs have been around sniffing the entire stadium. But we feel safe. This is fun. Notre Dame, Tennessee. The Volunteers, a touchdown favorite to improve on the season to 6-1. Notre Dame is 3-4. Bob Davie needs a win. They're calling for his job. This one should be fun, Rudy. And the show has been fun, too.
It's been great being with you, Mark. Thanks for joining us, and thanks for being with us. Let's do it.
All right. UT Notre Dame next here on NBC. We appreciate you watching. Enjoy the game, everybody, and have a great day.